Hi, welcome to this video class. In the last video, you have learned how the cyclones are formed. So in this video, you are going to learn the destructions caused by cyclones. Cyclones are very destructive. The speed of the wind push the water towards the shore. Even the storm is 100 kilometers away. So these are the first indications of an approaching cyclone, sir. Then how are these formed? They are the low pressure in the eye lifts water surface in the center, and the rising water may be as high as 3 to 12 meters. It appears like a water wave, and the pressure of this water wave is more so that the person cannot overcome that wave. So these water waves moving towards the shore, as a result the sea water enters the low lying coastal areas, causing severe loss of life and property, even which reduces the fertility of the soil. So this is the image of a cyclone, and also you can see that the water wave, so the rising water which looks like a water wave. This continuous heavy rainfall may further worsen the flood situations. High speed winds accompanying cyclone can damage houses, telephone and other communication systems, trees, etc., causing tremendous loss of life and property. So the clouds, these winds are responsible for the formation of a rain. So mostly the farmers in our country, they completely depend upon the rain for the harvest, but it may not be always a happy ending. Even these winds or rains may cause destructions. Yes, we all know that the storm is a low pressure system. So the wind speed is responsible for the formation of a storm. So it is necessary for us to know the measurement of the wind speed. So the instrument which is used to measure the wind speed is known as anemometer. So in the image you can see the picture of an anemometer which is used for measuring the speed of the wind. And these cyclones were called by different names in different parts of the world. In the American continents, where this cyclone is called as a hurricane, and if you just move on to the Philippines and Japan, it is called as typhoon. So the cyclone, it also is called by different names in different parts of the world. It may be called as cyclones or typhoons and also hurricane. Yes. And apart from cyclone, we are going to learn tornado. So what is meant by this tornado? And the main difference between the cyclone and a tornado is that cyclones, they occur in the water, whereas tornado, they takes place on the land. So a tornado is a dark funnel shaped cloud that reaches from the sky to the ground. A violent tornado can travel at speed about 300 km per hour. The whole coastline of India is vulnerable to cyclones, particularly the east coast. So this is the image of a tornado, which is like a funnel shaped structure which is narrow at the base and which meets the cumulonimbus clouds. And the diameter of the tornado can be as a meter as large and as a kilometer or even wider. The funnel of the tornado, it sucks dust, debris and everything near it at the base and throws him out near the top. And particularly during these situations when a tornado occurs, you have to bow on the knee and also try to protect your head and neck with your arms. So what are the effective measures to be taken when a cyclone approaches? So few safety measures are here for you. A cyclone forecast and warning service, rapid communication of warnings to the government agencies, the ports, fishermen, ships and to the general public. Construction of cyclone shelters in the cyclone prone areas and administrative arrangements for moving people fast to the safer places. So these are few effective measures to be taken. And what is the action on the part of the people when a cyclone approaches? So we should make necessary arrangements to ship the essential household goods, domestic animals and vehicles to safer places. Avoid driving on roads through standing water as the roads might have damaged. Keep ready the phone numbers of all the emergency services. Then, what are the precautions to be taken if you are in a cyclone affected area? You should not drink the water as it could be contaminated, and you should not touch the wet switches and fallen power lines which may give a shock. Or do not just go out just for the sake of fun. Do not pressurize the rescue force by making undue demands. Cooperate and help your neighbors and friends. So these are few precautions to be taken by the people, those who are living in the cyclone affected areas. Advanced technology has helped. Yes, these days the world is completely changed. In the early past of the last centuries, the coastal residents have had not less than a day to vacate to evacuate the places on the oncoming cyclone. But these days it is totally different. We thank the satellites and radars. A cyclone alert or cyclone watch is issued 48 hours in advance of any expected storm, and a cyclone warning is issued 24 hours in advance. So this happens with the help of satellites and radars. The message is broadcast every hour or half an hour when a cyclone is nearer the coast. And also many national and international corporations, they just help us during these cyclone disaster. Yes, so many national and international organizations, they cooperate and monitor the cyclone related disasters. So in this video you have learned what are the precautions to be taken when a cyclone comes. Yes, thank you.